Hi, welcome again in Differential Coach class. And this video, I will show you how to solve the case of inexact ordinary differential equation. So previously, we already looked at the exact solution and then what happened if we got the inexact ordinary differential equation. It's easy. Before this or in the previous video, you have if you have dm over dy is equal to dn over dx, this one is called exact differential equation. So what if this kind of differential equation, this kind of form, we have dm over dy is not equal to dn over dx. So when we have this kind of form, meaning that this equation is called inexact differential equation. So we cannot solve directly as the exact ODE. So we need to multiplying by what we call integrating factor. So we multiplying this this equation with the integrating factor so that we can obtain the exact differential equation back. Okay, meaning that this equation, we need to obtain the integrating factor. We multiply the integrating factor into the previous equation or the original equation, and then we try to check back to obtain this kind of form. So when we got dm over dy is equal to dn over dx, so this one is exact, then we can solve similarly as we did before this. Okay, the point here is how to determine the integrating factor. Okay, that's what we need to discuss before we move to the example. So if we assume the integrating factor is the function of x alone, which is that, let's say I is I function of x, the integrating factor is then given by this form, or similar to the function of y, so in this form. So let's look at for this one only, and then the rest you can try by using the integrating factor of y alone. Okay, let's straight away we go to the example of the inexact equation. So again, I think maybe it's better I move to the pages so that I can write down step by step. Okay, let we look at the example as in your slide. The first example we have dy over dx is equal to minus 2 over y minus 3y over 2x. Solve this differential equation. Okay, so first we need to follow the step previously. We need to write down this equation in the form of mxy dx plus n dxy dy equal to 0. So from this equation we can write down as okay, let's say, actually I'm already simplified this form to be in this form so that we have this form of equation, that this one is m, this one is n. Okay, so check the exactness. Either dm over dy is equal to dn over dx or not. So when we have m here is 4x plus 3xy, we differentiate with respect to y, we got 6y, and then we differentiate n, which is like this one, with respect to x, so we got 2y. So from here we can see that dm over dy is not equal to dn over dx. So this one is not nz. And then we can transform this equation to be nz by multiplying the equation with the integrating factor. So we need to determine the integrating factor first so that we can solve this equation. So the integrating factor, this one we have a quite big blanks here so that I can write down here. So let fx in the integrating factor in this here, so that fx is this one, this fx, so this fx is this one, and then we need to differentiate this fx to be the power of exponential there. Okay, so again maybe I use the right one. The integrating factor, the ix is equal to e to power of the integrating of f x dx. Okay, so we need to determine the fx first. So as here fx is 1 over n dm over dy dn minus dn over x, and then when we transform we change the value, we got this one, so we got fx is equal to 2 over x, but the integrator factor is e, this one, so we need to integrate fx with respect to dx, so that we integrate 2 over x dx. So integrate this one, we got 2 ln x, so that the integration of fx dx is equal to 2 ln x, so that our integrating factor is x is equal to e to power of 2 ln x, and then this one we can be simplify as x squared. Okay, so for this one, how this one become this one, check ln rule, you can check by yourself. Okay, so we got right now the integrating factor ix is equal to x squared. So we multiply this integrating factor into the original equation, which is that this one. We multiply into this one. Where is it? Okay, we multiply the differential equation by integrating factor. When we multiply x squared into this one, into this one, so we can obtain this equation. So we repeat back the step to check the exactness and everything. We check the exactness for m. This one is m, and this one is n. We differentiate d m over dy. We differentiate d n over dx, so that from here we obtain this one and this one. So we can say that we obtain dm over dy is equal to dn over dx. So this one is exact. So when this equation is exact, the next step is we solve similar as we did in exact ODE. Okay, so let's we look at here. First step, let u equal to here they use f, so let u, okay, first step, this one is the solution, is the solution. And then you integrate this mx, m, which is that this one, This one is m. Where is the m? Okay, this one. Integrate this one with respect to x. So you will obtain u, or the solution fxy here. This one. And the second step, you differentiate f, differentiate du dx, or differentiate n here with respect to dy, which obtain the fx here. And then the solution of this differentiation, you can obtain this one. So since this one is fx solution, so this one is solution, you can compare the equation 1 and equation 2. You can compare here, and then this one is similar to this one. So we have this one, x squared is the function of x, this one. So this one, we have this function of x, and other one, this one is constant. So we have c is a constant. So general solution for this one is fx xy is equal to x cubed y squared is equal to c. So this one is the solution for this inexact differential equation. And again, as you can see, that you need to check the exactness, determine the integrating factor, multiply the integrating factor with the original equation, check back the exactness, and then solve similar as we did before this to obtain the solution for inexact differential equation. So they have another example here, you can try by yourself step by step there. And again, thank you very much. If you have any question, you can text me in the chat box, and see you again in next video.